Hi, this is Scott Garibay, and today I'm going to be talking about Comic Star Horror, which is a summary of all the movies that Hollywood is passionate about today. Okay, so let me break this out a bit. So Comic Star Horror is just a quick mnemonic that I've created to talk about the movies that Hollywood is most passionate about today overall. Now, Comic Star Horror, this mnemonic is basically a mnemonic that captures a really cool idea that Jeremy Johns put forward in one of his videos. So Jeremy Johns, he's a reviewer on YouTube. I really like his content. He's got a really unique style. He's got his own voice, right? You know, and when he reviews movies, he really is reviewing in his own way. He reviews a pretty wide, he reviews a good number of movies, puts out videos on a high frequency. His videos are very high quality. Really like his stuff. So Jeremy Johns. And I'm also now convinced he's a pretty smart guy, because this comment was absolutely brilliant. All right, so Jeremy Johns is doing a review for Maze Runner 3. Okay, I didn't even know what the special name is, but Maze Runner 3. I've seen the first two Maze Runners. And he says, you know, Maze Runner 3, no spoilers in this, by the way. He says, Maze Runner 3, and he goes, a new YA movie, and a continuation of a YA series. And he goes, wait, does Hollywood make young adult movies anymore? I thought that was done. He goes, actually, does Hollywood make any movies anymore other than comic book movies, Star Wars, and bad horror? And Jeremy Johns made this as an off, like a little joke, like, ah, ha, ha, so here's my little joke, right? And I was like, holy crap, that's brilliant, right? And I thought about it, and I was like, oh, man, he's onto something there, right? And so what he was saying is that really, you don't really see many regular movies anymore. And I thought, wow, that is, and so Comic Star Horror is a summarization to say, we have a problem today, and that is that Hollywood does not bother to make regular movies anymore in large numbers, or that they're passionate about. There are certainly regular movies that are made, right? But Hollywood isn't making them generally. It's being done by the indie circuit, and Hollywood isn't excited about them. So you don't get that Hollywood energy. You don't get that Hollywood money. You don't get that Hollywood momentum. You don't get that Hollywood quality, right, on a regular movie. Hollywood, money, momentum, quality, energy, that is all preserved for comic star horror, right? So let's look at those three buckets, right? Comic book movies. Do we even need to talk about that one? They are absolutely ubiquitous now. They are just spread across the movie landscape like a guzzling behemoth, right? You know, I play Pokemon Go. I play Pokemon CCG, and there's this thing called the Guzzlord, right? You know, and like that's what comic book movies are now. They're the Guzzlord of like this huge ravening beast that just eats everything in its path, right? That's what a Guzzlord is in Pokemon CCG. And you know, like it's just like, whoa, man, this, you know, like, comic book movies are just, they are a force to be reckoned with now. And they have taken Hollywood by storm in every possible way. Every vestige has fallen, right? To comic book movies. They're all over every single season of the movie season, right? There's a few months that don't have them, but everywhere else you're going to see a comic book movie. They take a lot of energy and time, you know, just from movie perspective overall. They always take that, you know, that time and energy. And, you know, they're just... And the other thing is that I think we saw in 2017 is there are no more actors left. Every actor in Hollywood, everybody who wants to make it, realizes you have to get into a comic book movie. And the reason you have to get into a comic book movie is, that just drives every other property you have, right? So, you know, the whole... You know, if you get into a big comic book movie, you're going to be on every junket. You're going to have lots of people interviewing you. They're going to be interested in everything you say about the movie, and they're going to give you some attention on everything you want to say beyond the movie. And it's absolutely critical. Like, it's just, you know, I remember Benedict Cumberbatch, amazing, amazing actor. And everybody was like, we all know he's amazing. When's he going to get into a comic book movie? And we know he has to get there because that is the natural stage of evolution for every single actor today, because comic books comic book movies have eaten the world. Now, like, and that's, it's huge, right? Star Wars. Let's talk about Star Wars. Hollywood, oh, by the way, Hollywood is excited about comic movies because they are guaranteed moneymakers. Guaranteed moneymakers. All of these are guaranteed moneymakers. Comic book movies, Star Wars movies, bad horror. Okay, but let's break them out individually. All right, so Star Wars, right? What kind of money do they make? Well, Star Wars Force Awakens made $2 billion, right? And there's only three $2 billion movies in the world, right? It's Avatar, Avengers, and Force Awakens. That's it. That's all the $2 billion movies that exist, right? And it's really interesting that Avatar is not a comic book movie or a Star Wars movie. It's pretty interesting. But you know, just really speaks to the power of James Cameron. So, you know, this is really, really incredible, right? So you have this situation. It's really incredible situation overall at just how powerful these movies are. Star Wars, and it. So now, you know, but what about Rogue One? What about Last Jedi, right? Those are billion-dollar films. Each one made $1 billion. Rogue One was an interstitial. It was a movie that is not even in the main trilogy for Star Wars, right? It's just an interstitial movie, still made $1 billion, right? That's just incredible, right? It's just absolutely incredible. So these, you know, these films, they are mammoth, right? $1 billion is a layup for a Star Wars movie, and that's why Hollywood is so, so excited about Star Wars movies. So a ton of time, energy, money, and quality goes into those Star Wars films, right? And actually, that's another thing. Money, time, energy, and quality go into even people just talking about Star Wars on the internet. The scope of comic star horror is so big, it's amazing, right? Now, let's talk about that last one, bad horror. Jeremy John said this, bad horror, right? He says, you know, like, that's all Star Wars, that's all Hollywood makes now. It's comic book movies, Star Wars, and bad horror. The two words, bad horror, are just absolutely fascinating, right? And the reason why I'm really fascinated by this bad horror idea is he's right. He's 100% right. Bad horror. And the reason why is, how can you make money? Why is Hollywood excited about bad horror? About bad movies? Well, the reality is the horror genre is so unique and so unusual that you can easily make money on a bad horror movie. If you get lucky and your horror movie's great, awesome. We love it, right? It's icing on the cake, right? But the reality is bad horror movies make money. That's why there are so many Saw movies. I don't even know what number they're on right now. They're either on like 8 or 9. It's ridiculous, right? So that's the issue, is you can make a lot of money on bad horror movies. Bad horror movies. That's incredible. Like, that is a really, really unique aspect of the overall, it's incredible. It's really, really kind of unprecedented, right? So it's very, very, you know, interesting aspect of Hollywood overall. So it's really a very, very interesting way of thinking about movies overall. Now, okay, so once we acknowledge this problem, right? Once we acknowledge that we have this issue where Hollywood is just making these bad horror movies, right? That they're most passionate about these movies. We have to think about, why is it? Why is it that Hollywood just wants to make comic book movies? Why is it that they just want to make, why is it that they're only interested in making comic book movies, Star Wars movies? Why they're only really passionate about comic book movies, Star Wars movies, and bad horror? And the reason why is they're guaranteed money makers, you know, and in Hollywood, at the decision level, right, at the executive level, they have got to produce. There's incredible pressure to produce. You have to have major successes. So Hollywood is incredibly risk averse. They are highly, highly risk averse, right? So they do not want to gamble, right? They want to make a movie and know that movie is going to make some serious cash, right? It's very, very important to them. So one of the things that we have to realize is, I think this means even more so that Netflix is even more important than we thought Netflix was. And the reason why is Netflix is making 80 movies a year. 80 movies a year, right? So, like, that's incredible, right? And I just watched a movie called Stepsisters. It's incredible. Hollywood would have never touched this film because it's not a moneymaker. It's a work of art, right? And, like, pure work of art. Now, I think the Star Wars movies are works of art, absolutely. And I think there are comic movies that are works of art. But that's secondary to Hollywood, you know, as far as what they're passionate about. They really want a guaranteed moneymaker. And so I think Netflix is really, really important. The other thing is, we as moviegoers, it's on us to realize this and say, if we want regular movies, we really need to start, you know, going to see them, right? It's important that all of us this year, we should pick 4, 5, 6 movies that are not comic movies, that are not Star Wars movies, that are not bad horror movies or horror movies overall, and go see them, or we're not going to get any other movies. It's really critical. This is on us. Thank you. Take care.